Okay, so an alternative name for this video could have been how to make your glute exercises more glutey, because that's kind of what we're doing here. So many runners end up not really seeing the benefit of their glute exercises because of the way in which they're doing them. Technique-wise, they're not actually hitting the right muscles. I'm going to show you five exercises that we're so commonly given as runners to use to strengthen our glutes and show you where people go wrong and how you can make them far more effective. Let's start with the bridge. So we're going to start out on your back, as you'd imagine for a bridge. And from here, very straightforward, what I see people doing all the time in terms of their bridges is they set up with too long of a start position. Okay, they're creating too long of a lever with the legs. So they're here with their feet. As they come up into a bridge, even if they're getting the cues right of engaging their core, gently squeezing their butt, lifting, 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 kind of peeling their spine off the ground from bottom upwards. In this position, they end up starting to talk about cramping in their hamstrings rather than work through their glutes. Why is that? Well, in this long position, this long lever position that they find themselves in, those hamstrings are far more advantaged to actually be able to create hip extension, mechanically advantaged to be able to create hip extension than those glutes are. So what we can do is shorten up the position, put your heel in towards your butt, push down through the heel. And in this position, those hamstrings, well, they're pretty much just kind of quietened down and told to shut up. And instead, these glutes are the muscle group with mechanical advantage. They are the ones that push you up into the bridge. And straight away, I can feel the work here in comparison to those hamstrings doing the work when I was here. The other thing while we're in a bridge is to talk about pushing through the heels. And I want you to try this for yourself. When you're in a bridge position, come up and push into the heels and then switch it up and push through the forefoot. As soon as you start pushing through the forefoot, it's all quads. If you push through the heels, it forces you to use that posterior chain. Okay, now next up, if that was a few little tips for your bridge, another real simple exercise that people don't really get the most out of is a squat. Yeah, a bodyweight squat, as simple as it gets. But there's a big difference between with a bodyweight squat, starting out feet, shoulders width apart, keeping your back straight, starting out breaking at the hip first, sitting your butt back and down. Big difference between this and kind of finishing here versus this and squeezing that last little inch or so out of hip extension, getting the hips through and consciously squeezing your butt at the top. I'm not talking about overextending, hyperextending through your low back. I'm not talking about that at all. I'm just talking about completing the movement, getting to the top consciously, squeeze your butt. So we're here, squeeze, pushing the hips into that final position at the top of the squat. If you're simply getting here and just rushing through into the next rep and not completing that last inch, we're not really working in any kind of even to neutral at the hip, let alone into any hip extension. We're staying slightly flexed the whole way through. And of course, as runners, what we're really after is getting glute max working to push us into hip extension here. So we need to practice extending. The top of a squat is a nice, safe, easy, stable way of getting better at working into extension. Of course, then we build that into our kind of single leg movements, and we have the same conversation at the top of our various different single leg exercises where, again, we finish the movements. We get the hip through, squeeze those glutes. Now, from there, we move back down to the ground. People go wrong all the time, even without a resistance band, when doing things like the simple clamshell exercise here. What we're after with a clamshell exercise or any side-lying exercise is making sure that you're not bailing out into rotation. Hips stacked one on top of the other, if anything, slightly forwards facing, so you're slightly rolling in towards the ground, will emphasize the muscles at the back here. So that will feel very glutey in comparison to being rolled out like this, where in this position, lifting up, getting a lot more TFL, tensor fasciae latae. Now the problem is, where people have been given this exercise to combat ITB syndrome, they've been told, do lots of clamshell exercise, strengthen up glute med, really start to work on creating a little bit more strength through the outside of the hip there, they end up actually strengthening, if they're bailing out here, strengthening the muscle that's already overworked, already overly tight, creating, or at least in part, creating the ITB issue in the first place. That muscle tensor fasciae latae, TFL, can be kind of troublesome. So working slightly forwards, the easiest way to do that is reach with the hand. That will put you in the right position, trust me, when you're doing a clamshell. Try that in comparison to that. Completely different exercise. Okay, then to finish off, we're going to go through a single leg balance exercise and then an exercise that we see all the time people bailing out of and just wasting their time with. So, single leg squat. Big old difference between how a lot of people do a single leg squat, which is more of a exercise loading up the knee and the ankle. So they're here, especially our kind of mini squats given by the physio a lot of the time. Here, as opposed to here, loading up the hip. Okay, let me show you that from side on. The easiest way to do that, in fact, is to have something to reach to. So let me use the box here. Side on, if I show you the first variation, which is keeping the torso fairly upright, you can see that most of this movement is coming from the knee, coming from the ankle. If we look at the range of motion here at the hip, I stay fairly open at the hip joint. In comparison, if I reach forwards, look at how much more hip flexion goes on. The forwards reach forces me to sit my butt back, forces me to load my glutes, and guess what? It's what we said earlier. As we get to the top of the movement, bang, hip through, squeeze your butt. So it's down, forwards reach, and squeeze. That again helps us get a lot more out of our glutes with a simple single leg exercise. Now the last one of these is our donkey kicks. We see people doing donkey kicks quite often, either with or without resistance bands. A lot of the time they're doing it with a resistance band, they're completely overloaded and they're working way too hard through their lower back. What I want to see with a donkey kick is isolation. I want to see you working the hip. You may not be working through a huge range of motion, but look how still my lower back is here in comparison to that, which you see all the time. People working really hard through their lower back, rocking forwards with their pelvis, not really using their glutes. This is more of a back workout than isolating those glutes and keeping the pelvis and the lumbar region really static. So that is just a handful of different ways you can make these exercises way more glutey, way more effective. But if you're not sure whether you're using your glutes or not, check out the video right over here, because this is going to give you some real solid answers to that question, so you'll know what you need to focus on.